Hi friends, when we discuss about the characteristics of the living things, we discuss that the living things need food, living things breathe, living things move, living things grow, and living things have a sensation. So these are the few characters we studied in earlier class. Now in this class we study the next important characters of the living things, that is the reproduction. Means all the living things include plant and animals produce living things of their own kind. Living things of their own kind, this is the important one. So the human being reproduce and give the produce the human beings. The dog produce the puppies, means the animal like themselves. So that's why they called of their own kind. They produce the young ones of their own kind. The animals are reproduced in a two way. First is the oviparous and second is the viviparous. So what is mean by the oviparous? And animals reproduce through laying the eggs. What is the definition of the oviparous? An animal that lay eggs to reproduce, it's called the oviparous. Example, birds in our surrounding lay the eggs. The best example of the laying eggs is hen. We say the eggs of the hen is very big, so we can easily see. But the eggs of the fish and insects are very very tiny. We can't see with our open eyes. In the same way, the lizards, house lizard and other lizards or reptiles lay the eggs, include the snake. Then the next one is the viviparous, an animal that give the birth to the young ones. As we know, we are grow inside our mother's tummy, and later on the animal give the direct birth to the young ones. So those animals are called the viviparous. What is meant by viviparous? An animal that give birth to the young ones. They give the birth. The animals are developed inside the parents or mother's tummy. Sorry. So cow, dog, cat, human beings, elephant, and most of the developed animals are reproduced through viviparous, or it is reproduced, or they give the birth to their young ones. All the mammals except the bat, all the animals give the birth to their young ones. Sorry, bat also give the direct birth to the their young ones. Bat is the only mammal that is flying. So correct your information. So most of the plant reproduce through the seed. As we know, this is the season. Now in this season we saw the seed inside the soil. This soil, this seed is germinated and grow into the plants. So this is called the germination of the seed. See, this is the figure which show the germination of the seed. In this case, in the first picture, the seed is sprouted. When get the sufficient amount of water, air and sunlight. It is sprouting, and then it is growing into the small plant. We call it as seedlings, and then day by day it is growing and grow into the adult plant. So this is the germination of the seed. In this way, the plants are reproduced. Some plants are reproduced through the stem. For example, potato. Potato reproduced through its stem. And the mint is reproduced through their stem. So these are the examples of the some plants. Some plants reproduce through roots. And best example is the sweet potato. And the plants would reproduce with the stem are potato and the turmeric one or mint. Thank you.